I'm here with Lottie Tomlinson for her new launch in collaboration with Nails Inc. for The Matchbox. You started your career with Lou Teasdale. What three top tips has she taught you?
To be as helpful as you can, stay out of the way when necessary, and when it comes to beauty and hair, just less is more.
And you now have 2.9 million followers, which is amazing. What is your most popular post to date, if you can remember?
I think it was when I did the rainbow roots in my hair. I think that went crazy, yeah. And that was a really popular post.
And is that the point that your Instagram kind of exploded?
I think it was more of like a gradual thing once I started going on tour and stuff like that, and it just really gradually went up and up.
What's been the biggest highlight of your career so far?
Probably this collaboration. It's been so much fun and I was really involved, and it's just really reflects me.
And who would you most like to work with?
Probably the Kardashians, because they're just every makeup artist's dream.
And who have you done that you enjoy doing makeup on the most?
I work a lot with Louisa Johnson. I love doing her. She's really
beautiful. She's great. Lovely face.
Yeah.
So you have 10 minutes to get ready. What are your quick fix products, and do you have any little tricks on how to use them?
I think I'd just do concealer, loads of mascara, lip balm, bit of bronzer.
And you're always playing around with different makeup. How do you keep your skin so clear?
I think just not sleeping in your makeup, making sure you've always got time to do a good cleanse, tone and moisturise before you go to bed, and drinking a lot of water helps.
That's a good one. And what's the best beauty hack you've ever known?
Probably putting tape here. A really liner. Strong liner, or if you're just wanting to have like a really sharp line here with your hair makeup.
And what beauty rules do you swear by?
I don't think there is any rules with beauty. I like to just do kind of whatever.
Yeah. And do you have any beauty no-nos?
I don't think so. I think I just like to try, test stuff, and then if it doesn't work, then it doesn't work, but I like to try. I like to go against the rules a bit.
What's the most like extreme thing you've done for yourself then?
Well, I think a lot of people say don't do dark eyes and dark lips, but I think that's actually like a really good look if you do it properly. Don't do too much.
So your hair, which you mentioned before, it's a huge talking point because you're always changing the colour. So what advice would you give to girls who want to start colouring their hair, and how do you keep it in such good condition?
I think it's just great to know like your boundaries of your hair. So obviously mine's only naturally dark blonde, so I can go really light with it, whereas if you were really dark, you wouldn't be able to go so light. And just doing treatments, conditioning it, trying to keep it at the best condition.
Do you have any like favourite treatments that you get at salons, or do you have a favourite one?
My favourite is the bleach reincarnation mask. I use that like nearly every time that I wash, and that really helps.
So you take amazing selfies, as seen on your Instagram. What's the secret to the perfect one, and do you have like an angle that you know works best for you?
I think it's got to be the selfie ring light. Can't go wrong when you've got that on.
So do you use like a Lumi, or do you have like an attached?
Literally.
Oh, like, you have one like
there,
that.
Yeah.
Amazing. And who are your biggest beauty icons?
Probably someone like Beyonce, Rihanna. I think they do like some amazing things with their looks.
And who do you follow on Instagram that you find inspiring? Not necessarily beauty, but anyone.
A really good page that I follow is called Huda Beauty. It just has
amazing
videos.
Love that one.
Like, you find so many cool tips on there. That's my favourite.
Right, so landing a contract with Nails Inc. must have been so exciting. How did you feel when they asked you to be the face of their new collection?
It was very overwhelming and really exciting and a bit nerve-wracking at first. It's kind of the first collab that I've ever done, but I just really enjoyed it, and obviously it's so exciting.
And also for it to be lips, because you always do lipstick tutorials stuff. What are your go-to nail shades for autumn winter?
I think out of my Matchbox, Buzzin and Hell. So these two.
I love this one. Are you wearing this one now?
Yeah, I am actually, yeah. With a matte top coat.
Very nice. And what are your top tips for flawless nail painting?
Base coat. And then just really thin coats when you apply the colour, and then a top coat.
Great, nice and simple.
Yeah.
Are there any easy nail art looks that are easy for beginners?
I think the best thing is just to use like glitters and stuff like that. I think they're quite easy to work with if you're just trying new stuff, definitely.
And tell us your favourite perfumes, both a day and night one.
My favourite is the Charlotte Tilbury Dream. I just wear that all the time, day and night. It's really,
okay,
really nice.
That's your all-time favourite at the moment.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. Lastly, what do you hope to achieve next in your career?
I think just doing more makeup, more collabs, hopefully. Loads of. I've got a book coming up, which is really exciting.
Oh, do you? That's amazing.
Yeah. So
the Matchbox collection is out now and it's £15. Thank you so much.
Thank you.